Georgia's next game is Florida. You know, looking back at your time as a coach, what did that rivalry mean to you, and you know, kind of what have you seen it develop into?
Well, it was a week that, for some reason, really stimulated the competitive juices of our football team. Every time that you just mentioned the name Florida in Jacksonville, and they got very competitive, stood tall up particularly that week, so it was, to them, a big, big game. And I didn't have to say anything to them, which is a great thing, because they were excited about playing and excited about competing.
I guess, tell me about the SEC race this year. You know, it's shaped up kind of interesting. You know, what are your thoughts on who's kind of in position in the East here, you think, and who do you think you know, has the best position in the West with Alabama and LSU?
Well, I really think Georgia has the best position to win the East right now in light of a lot of things. First of all, they're good, and they've gotten better. And secondly, certainly with the loss of South Carolina's tailback, then that certainly is going to increase South Carolina's chances of losing. I think even if they had Lattimore, that they would get beat by Arkansas anyway. I think Georgia, on the other hand, has a more favorable schedule. If you don't play LSU, Alabama, and Arkansas, then because of the scheduling part of it, they're certainly in a good position to win. I think they certainly have the best chance of beating Florida that they've had in a long, long time. And it may all come down to the Auburn game, which that has happened so many times where the championship is on the line.
And when you were a coach, did it seem like, you know, so many things this year have kind of fallen in place for Georgia after the first few weeks, you know, to help them? You know, they've been winning, but little things have fallen in place to help them get to where they're at now, you know, at the top of the East. I mean, were there years when you were a coach that just seemed to happen, where you had to convince players that, you know, keep winning and these things will fall back into place for us?
Yeah, I think that, I mean, I really wasn't that concerned about the Boise State game, because I really think Boise State might have beaten us 3 out of 4 times. They are really good, and they deserve to be where they are. If they had a little tougher schedule, they'd be even better. It was really disheartening to lose the South Carolina game, because I think Georgia outplayed South Carolina. But as you know, the big turnover was not just turnovers that hurt, but these were disastrous turnovers because of immediate touchdowns that resulted from that. But then I thought that Georgia would start to catch fire, and I think they have. They've got you've got to be able to survive a game like they did against Vanderbilt. I've been there many a time on a Saturday night in Nashville, and if you just come out with a win, I don't care how you come out with a win, you feel good, and I think that Georgia did that.
Yeah. And, you know, what are your thoughts on the East versus West this year in the SEC? It seems like the East, the popular belief is the teams are kind of beating each other up, while in the West, you know, there's LSU and Alabama. You know, what are your thoughts on kind of the way those teams will match up?
Well, it's, I don't think that I've ever seen two teams in the West that good at one time. And they are really good. Arkansas is really good. They're a top 10 team, and Alabama handled them pretty well on the road. But, I don't recall when I've seen Alabama and LSU, two teams that good, and it's going to be one heck of a football game when the time comes, because both of them are so physical and both of them are so athletic that it's going to be. And it's interesting because neither one of them have what you'd call a great quarterback.
Yeah.
Boy, they got everything else, and maybe it's good they don't have a great quarterback because the way they're playing, it's really something, and I can't wait to watch that ball game.
Yeah. And finally, you know, there's been a lot of attention paid this week to the argument between Georgia's Todd Grantham and Vanderbilt's you know, Coach Franklin. What, when you're a coach, I mean, how hard is it to control your emotions, or how emotional does it get out there, you know, in a close game like that?
Yeah. Well, it's a very emotional and passionate game, I know that. And I'm not going to address a particular situation, but I have a general thought about it.
Yeah.
I think that a coach has even more responsibility than the players do in sportsmanship. And players do have a responsibility in sportsmanship. Because the players look to the coaches. So I think because of that, they have a responsibility of example. And what kind of example can they accept for them? So I'm very strongly in favor of as much as it hurts, and it hurts when you lose, is to be able to suck it up, keep it inside, and be a gentleman, and somehow, some way, shake hands, and then take off. You don't have to visit behind me. But I think it means a great deal to the game of football that coaches conduct themselves that way.